Hey guys, and welcome to SSIS 101. In this video, you will learn the following things: how to submit data to an API service from any source just in a few clicks, how to batch data and submit it in just one request, how to parse the response from an API, also how to handle errors. In this part, we will query a SQL database table, transform each row into a JSON, and then submit multiple JSONs one by one to a REST API service. Even though in this particular example, we will be using a SQL database as our source and a REST API service as destination, in your case, you can use any source and submit data to SOAP web service too. Okay, we can start. So first of all, open Visual Studio, select File, New Project, and create new integration services project. So to move on, find data flow task, click Edit, then find AutoDB source to get some data. Let's attach the connection, and now let's write a very simple query to get the data. So we will be using just this five customers. We can note one so that later we can identify that it was submitted to an API. So Maria Anders. Okay, close, click OK. So once we have the rows, we need to transform them into JSONs. So find JSON generator transform in SSIS toolbox and drag it into data flow. Connect with AutoDB source and click edit. So now we can construct our JSON. On mappings, right click and select add elements. I will add all the columns. And this is the preview of the JSON will be generated. So column names become properties and values go here. Okay, so now we can submit the JSONs into REST API. So find web API destination, drag it into data flow, and connect with the JSON generator transform. So now to proceed, you will need to select and create new connection, HTTP or OAuth. So you should use HTTP connection when you are making a simple HTTP request. Also when no authentication is required, or when your API provider lets you to embed the API key in the URL or in headers. There is another option, OAuth. It's safer, it doesn't send credentials over the wire each time, and it also allows scopes to be defined. So if you have a choice to use HTTP or OAuth, shoot with OAuth. So sorry, we will be using HTTP this time because we will be making simple HTTP requests. I will enter the site, test the connection, click OK, everything works. Okay, so now we can move on with URLs. There are three places you can input URL. It's in the connection manager, it's in input column for URL place, and also you can enter it in here in URL in settings. So I would completely ignore URL in HTTP connection manager and use only these two. So if you have dynamic URLs coming from upstream, so definitely you should use this one. And if you have a constant URL, meaning it won't change with each request. You can use just a simple paste it, I mean enter it here in settings area. Also, you may have you may want to use URL in settings when you want to test request response, because when you press test request response button, URL will be taken from settings because it cannot be taken from here because there is still no data. Okay, so we have a constant URL and I will input it here, http://bin.org/post. That's our URL for posting. And now we have to configure the body. The body will be dynamic. It will be changing with each row because each row means each new JSON. So we just select ZS JSON out column, which was generated by, created by JSON generator transform. There is also a property here, body request data. The logic's very similar as with this URL. So if you have a constant body, you will be sending to an API. You can enter it here, and if it will be changing, it will be dynamic, you enter it here. I should mention that there is a priority. If you enter the body, let's say here, and you also have input column for body as column, on runtime, web API destination will always take dynamic body, and also it will same apply to URL. So these take precedence over these settings. Okay, now you also have body content type. In our case, we will need JSON, but let's say if you want to submit an HTTP form, web form, so you would use this one. Or if you're submitting to SOAP web service, you would choose something similar like this or this. Okay, so let's select JSON. Also, there is an option to add a new HTTP header. Some APIs require you to do that. We don't need it at this time. Okay, so we're ready to submit some data. I opened a nice free tool, which is called Telerik Fiddler Web Debugger. It will allow us to see what requests are made by web API destination and let you see what's happening under the hoods. Okay, so let's run the package. So we are expecting 5 rows. Expecting 5 JSONs to be generated, so both are done, and 5 requests to be made. So here you go, 5 requests. We're looking for Maria. Where is Maria? Ah, here is Maria. So yeah, first request, we submitted this kind of JSON. Here you take a look, and HTTP service returned us with this response. So that's it. Basically, that's how you submit data from any source to your API service. In this part, we will improve the solution we created previously. We will group rows into batches, thus submitting them in fewer requests. Also, you will learn how to retry requests on failure and how to set throttling option. Okay, so we start from where we left. Configure web API destination again. To enable batching, click batch settings and click this checkbox. So what web API destination does when batching is enabled, it just concatenates the JSONs or the bodies you submit, let's say, from input column for bodies, and that's it. And let's say if you are batching JSONs and want them to be submitted as a multi-content JSON, you can just leave all these fields empty and set the batch size you want. However, we will be concatenating them into another JSON, and we will use this header and this footer. So our concatenated JSONs will go right here after this bracket and before this bracket. Okay, so to continue on throttling, so many API services limit the number of requests you can make per day or per some interval of time. To help you with that, you can configure throttling option. So web API destination component will wait a configured number of milliseconds after making each request. So just leave it as at 500. And lastly, there is retry settings. This red text says you should configure it in connection manager. You can retry requests on three modes. So the first one, when you just retry it on any error, you can set the number of times you want to retry and the wait time between each retry made. Also, there is an option to retry a request when a specific status code is retrieved from the response, and another option is to retry when a specific message is a specific text is in the error message unavailable, let's say. So okay, let's click OK. So that's it, we're ready to test our package. Okay, so two requests were made just as we expected. Here is our lovely Maria, and let's look at the formatted version. As you see, three JSONs were concatenated and put here, and in another request we have two JSONs. So that's it, that's how you group rows and submit batched data to an API service in fewer requests. In this part, we will review how to parse JSON response you get from web API destination and how to save parse data rows into a SQL database table. Okay, so web API destination is a wonderful component because not only you can use it as a destination when you submit data to HTTP service, some API service, you can also use it further along the path in your data flow, because you can also do something with the data you get from HTTP service or API service. So since I know that we are getting JSON responses, I will use JSON parser transform to parse the result. Have in mind that if you're using SOAP based web service, you could also use XML parser transform and parse the data, parse the XML into data rows. Okay, so I connected the two. And before I go into editing JSON parser transform, I will need a sample JSON to generate columns. So I will do that. I will take now the request I make. So basically I will put here the body and emulate the requests we're making when we are running the package. And to do that, I will just press test request response button. It sends the request and gives us back the response. Very handy. We just can copy the response we get. Surely you could do the same thing in Fiddler, but I'm just showing a more convenient way to do that. And here we go. We have JSON parser transform. So select here response text. It will be HTTP response you get from API service. And here I am pasting a sample JSON. And now we are able to parse the columns. Yeah, so the columns can be parsed only from sample JSON. It cannot be done from the column because data is still not there. Okay, pressing OK. So we have JSONs parsed into data rows, and we are now ready to save those rows into a SQL table. So let's create one. I'm creating here one, pressing OK. Don't forget the mappings. Click OK. And we are ready to run the package. So I'm showing that all of the DB destination is empty. I'm running the package. Okay, it's done. And here you see the response that was made. The response that we received. And here is the data. So the JSON is saved as rows in the table. So that's it. That's how you parse HTTP response from Web API destination and save the results into a SQL database table. In this part, I will show you how to handle errors and redirect the bad rows into another destination. Yeah, so sometimes the requests you make with API destination fail, and you get an error from your REST API service or API service, which means that requests were not carried out successfully. And at that point, they may want to save the JSON you submitted to service into some other destination, into your other system. So maybe you could do some analysis or maybe retry later, etc. So to do that, let's drag OLEDB destination and connect this red arrow, and then select on error, redirect the row, and redirect the row here. Click OK. Now let's create a table for that. Let's name it errors. Okay, let's create the mappings, click OK. And now I will modify URL to some, yeah, it's already modified to some non-existing one so that we could get some errors. Okay, let's run the package. Okay, so the rows were redirected here. I'm opening SSMS, and let's do some queries. So as you see, the request JSON is in the JSON out column, so you can retry submitting them later. And you also have the error message column where it says that the URL was not found. So that's how you handle the requests that were not carried out successfully at your end or in API service. To sum up, in this video you learn how to pull data from any source, transform it into a JSON, and push it to an API service just in a few clicks. For more videos like this, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.